Okay, so the blue came back. So I'm going to do another one with the red medium-sized fret. Now, medium fret is a little more challenging only because it takes longer for it to warm up and stick. And since in that first step I don't want to melt the Colvin yet, I've got to be a little more patient how long I hold it in the flame.
You said red takes longer to melt than blue?
Medium-sized fret.
Oh, medium-sized. Okay, I'm sorry.
Is a little more challenging, but it gives you a nice effect with sort of larger spots. And since the video turned off, this will get the folks online a chance to see how we make one too. I'm going to move to the map gas just so you can see the difference.
You're online?
I think so.
Yes.
Are we online? Yes.
Live.
Welcome. Live. So again, way up high, spinning rapidly, coming down slowly. I don't want to shock the glass by taking cold glass right into a hot flame, it could shatter. You can see it go faster. And the medium fret being bigger pieces takes a little longer to get soft and thick. You can see it changing color. It's gone from red to just about black. But it's not sticking yet. You have to be patient. Now it's beginning to stick. Because it takes so long to get stick, sometimes I begin to melt the whole thing too soon. So I gotta be careful and keep it up high out of the flame. The blue core is the hottest. I'm staying in the upper blue right now. And it's already getting soft. So now it's all stuck, I'm gonna come out. And now I'm gonna go straight into the hottest part of the flame. This is where we differ a bit from bead making, because in bead making you turn your flame down, you try to stay away from that super hot flame to work with the glass for making your beads. If we're making these blown ornaments, that's what we're looking for. So you can see how quickly it's getting floppy. The red color will come back. Another really fun element to work with these is the stringers.
We were looking at that.
Yeah.
Putting stringers on the inside, you get the spider webbing kind of effect. So you can experiment with this, of course. I like to use two stringers of complementary color. And I'll break them into 1-inch to 2-inch size lengths. And just put them down the straw like before. I want some long ones and some short ones. I'm hoping the short ones will sort of crisscross and stick across the width of the bulb like spider webs. We can combine our elements, of course. We can do some frit and some stringers all in the same bulb for different effects. And you can use more or less.
Yeah.
Already capture all the pieces, nothing goes to waste.
Little pieces that broke off?
Yep.
Yeah. Try to do that with spaghetti.
Right? Get it all in the pot.
Yeah.
So here's that first step goes pretty quickly because I don't want all the stringers to melt and stick in the tip. I want them to stick all the way around. So again, I'm just going to warm it up. Well, I'm just moving slowly, giving it a chance to warm up. Buy the cold ones in a box of 100, go home and play with them all, and get pretty comfortable with it. So in a second, they're going to start to stick. They're already changing color inside there. Like I was saying, I only want a couple of them to stick at the tip. The rest of them I want to kind of bounce around and stick everywhere. I do have some larger ones. I don't quite know how to use them because, of course, the flame's only so wide. And since I want the whole thing to cook at the same time, that doesn't seem to work real well. It's not a good ratio. Blow right up, yep, and pop.
Is the stem on that hot?
No. The bulb is hot. You can hold it way down there on the bottom. So the way that I put dots on the outside is with glass rods. I'm going to put the blue frit on the inside. Once I get the frit to stick, I'm going to get my rod hot and dab some dots on the outside. These dots are going to be on the outside. Yep. So that is black frit on the inside and clear dichro flakes on the outside. So when the bulb was hot, I rolled it on the marver to pick up the flakes. And then pushed it again. This is back to the turquoise blue, the fine frit. So in a few seconds, I'm going to pull the Colvin up higher in the heat just to keep it warm, and I'll bring my rod in to get hot. When the rod's all melty orange hot at the tip, I'll bring the Colvin back down and pull a dot off the end of the rod. The rod was 18 inches long when we started. Now it's getting all melty. I'm going to come down and pull off a dot. will put the rod back on my rod rest. And I will finish the project like before. The dots will melt in completely. When I blow them back out, of course, they'll grow. So I'm staying about an inch and a half or two away from the tip of the torch. That's the hottest part of the flame. And I'm trying to keep the Colbin where that flame covers from the tip to the top to cook it all down at once. So the angle of the torch head is important, and me keeping my hand flat is important. If I were to try to dip the Colbin in like this, it would sort of elongate and droop. If I pulled it up that way, it would fold. So keeping it straight is important. And it gets all droopy. When it gets so droopy that I just can't control it, I'm afraid I'm going to lose the project. That's when I know it's time to blow it up. So this is one of the projects where I'll use the matte gas on purpose because it burns cleaner. Hopefully my white rod will come back as white dots.
Does it ever come back as something else?
Well, it can come back very muddy.
Oh.
That was a yellow stringer.
That looks kind of cool.
It does.
Now this one didn't quite make it. This is our test. See if the project is good enough to go home. They got too thin. Yeah.
It's a case of I want them to make it really, really big.
So they do better small. You know, it stays thicker and stronger. I've tried several ways of annealing the bulbs after blown. For instance, we put them in a bucket full of vermiculite. Vermiculite is an insulating type material that you get in the garden store. Didn't seem to make a difference. The bulb that was nice and small and well-formed and was going to survive here on the table did fine with vermiculite. But if it wasn't well-formed, the glass was too thick on one end or it was too big, they didn't last in the vermiculite either. In fact, they tended to break off kind of at the seam at the top. We tried putting them in the bead annealing kiln. Again, didn't save the ones that weren't going to make it anyway. I also saw a video of a woman who was taking it back to the flame. After she blew it this large, she would go back up in the flame and hold it up there for 4 or 5 minutes to do some annealing. I tried that. I got too close to the flame. My bulb kind of drooped. So that didn't work for me either. But this seems to work. And the lady that I took the class from a couple of years ago, this is the same way she did it. Uh-huh. Just put them right in the kiln post on the tabletop and let them cool. So there we are with some white dots.
That is so neat.
And I think the map gas did as well.
That's so cute.
Now to cut them off. To cut the stems off and put the caps on, I use a scoring knife.
Okay.
And that's like a garden tool sharpener. It's a piece of tungsten carbide on a metal handle. And I'll just turn it so I'm using the corner, that 45 degree corner, to score on the Colbin. So to do this, I like to hold it off the side of the table and cut right in that little narrow neck point and score a line all the way around. Take some pressure, you gotta push down a little bit. And then pull.
Very cool.
Now that little ragged edge will be covered up by the cap, but it can be cleaned up with a sickle stone or any abrasive sandpaper. Or your grinder, if you have a stained glass grinder at home, you can go to the grinder to clean it up. Or the real easy way is with the saw. So of course I could have cut it with a saw to start with, shut the water out, and not even bothered with the snapping it. So the little aluminum cap goes on top, and here's the hardest part of the whole project, is getting these little legs to fit inside them. Colbin.
Colbins.
A friend brought some to me. I have some larger Colbins, but when I tried using my torches to make an ornament, I found that the flame didn't cover the whole bulb.
That's right.
What the way that I missed
two tanks side by each.
And let the flames join?
Yeah.
I don't know. In Ghostbusters, they said, do not cross your streams.
Okay.
So, I'm not sure.
Gotta respect the Ghostbusters.
What happened?
So much.
You're welcome. Yeah, that one got a little eggy shaped, and that's okay.
It's Easter.
That's right.
Yeah.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you, sir.